Hi, I'm Anna, and I'm a researcher here at the British School at Athens. My research is on texts from prehistoric Greece, which are written in an early form of the Greek language, which we call Mycenaean, and in a script, which we call Linear B. These texts were written on small clay tablets, like this one that I'm holding now, and they were used about 3,000 years ago to keep administrative records in palaces around Greece, places like Knossos, Mycenae, Pylos, and Thebes. The texts of these tablets give us lots of information about the people who lived and worked in these palaces and the territories that they controlled. Here I've got some replicas that I've made of some tablets from the Palace of Pylos. This one is a record of a group of women and children who worked grinding grain to make flour. Then this next one is a record of some perfumed oil that's described as rose-scented being given out from a palace storeroom. And this last one lists offerings of grain being given by various people to the god Poseidon. So we can use these texts to reconstruct what people in the palaces were doing, their work, the palaces' economic activities, people's religious activities. But one group of people we don't know very much about are the people who actually created these documents. And understanding more about how the Linear B texts were created is the focus of my research here. That means not just how the texts were written, but also something that doesn't get talked about as much, namely how the tablets were made out of clay in the first place. Now, this might sometimes have been done by the writers themselves, sometimes by assistants or apprentices, we're not entirely sure. We do know that there were a few different ways the tablets could be made, and in this video we're going to look at some of these methods and explore the reasons why tablet makers might have chosen different methods and how that relates to the process of then writing on the tablets. This is something I've been investigating in the Fitch Laboratory here in the BSA using experimental archaeology. Doing experiments to try out activities like this is something that can really help us understand how people in the past made things, not just clay tablets, but pottery or textiles or even food, and why they might have used particular materials or methods in making those things. So I'm going to show you some of what I found while making my own tablets, and then you can have a go yourselves. We're going to be looking at the long, thin tablets like these ones. These are the records you just saw listing the flour grinders and the perfume oil. And these are called palm leaf tablets because of their shape. They're usually used for short, single items of information like this one work group, one issue of olive oil. Whereas the longer page-shaped tablets, like the ones with the records of offerings to Poseidon, have larger lists of more entries of information. Now, the easiest way to make a palm leaf tablet is simply take a ball of clay, roll it out into a sausage shape, like this, using one hand or both hands till it's about the right length, and then we're going to flatten it, palms of our hands, like this. We turn it over, we now have, and smooth it out a bit, we now have a nice flat surface for writing on. Now, this is a bit rough around the edges, we might want to neaten up the edges and smooth out the writing surface. The Mycenaean tablet makers generally took quite a lot of care over this. They aren't just roughly rolling out some clay. They're making some quite neat tablets most of the time. They probably used a tool of some kind to smooth the surface. We can see some of the markings from that sometimes. I'm going to use this clay modeling tool, which I'm going to dip in some water, and just use it to smooth out the surface that I'm going to write on, just to make it neater. And also to neaten up the edges, flatten them like this, and the edge there as well. You could just use your fingers and dip them in water in a similar way, if that's easier. And I'm gonna do that actually to tidy up the edges here a bit, just to make it look a bit more neat. Okay, so now I have a tablet that will be ready for me to write on, although ideally I'd leave it to dry a little bit before I do that. We know from looking at the actual tablets, which are mostly in museums in Greece, there are a few in the UK, that they weren't always made in this way. Some tablets were made in a slightly more complicated way. And that starts with, again, take a ball of clay, but this time I'm going to roll it out into a flat sheet. I'm going to use this rolling pin. I assume that Mycenaean tablet makers probably had something quite similar. So I'm going to roll it out into a sheet like this. And then what I'm going to do is fold it up along its longer edge, rolling it over once, and then another time. And now I've got again, a fairly similar sort of palm leaf shape. Now you can see that this one is going to need a lot more work to tidy it up. I'm going to need to smooth out this seam at the back where I folded it over. So I'm going to start by smoothing that out with my fingers like this. Usually this is almost completely smoothed over on the actual tablets. I need to kind of pinch the ends together as well. And we've smoothed over the joins at the ends there. So once I've done that with my fingers a bit, I'm going to use the clay tool again just to finish off, again, neatening up the edges. Making them flatter like I did with the first one. I'm going to smooth the writing surface. I might flatten it as well in the same way as I did the first one to give myself a flat surface, and then I can smooth that out. And you can see I've got a lot more work to do on this one. Basically, it's a fiddlier method. The clay often tends to crack around the edges where you folded it, and so you have to tidy that up. The back is still pretty messy, but that's okay. It's only the back, so I'm going to leave it. But I'll tidy the edges up a bit. Okay, so why would a tablet maker choose to use this more fiddly method when you could just roll out a clay sausage and then flatten it? Why bother with this folding? Well, if I pick up this tablet that I first made, you can see it sort of sags in the middle quite a bit. If I pick up this one that I've made by folding, I hope you can see it's much more sturdy. The folding prevents it from sagging and bending in that way. So this effect only lasts while the clay is quite wet. Once the tablets have dried, there's no real difference that you can see. But what the benefit of folding seems to be then is that if you're going to write on a tablet fairly soon after it's made, while the clay is still quite wet, it's easier to handle it, it's easier to write on it without it potentially bending and breaking if you've made it by this more complicated method of folding. So by choosing this method, the tablet makers are making it easier for the writer of the tablet, whether that's going to be the same person who then writes on it or somebody else who comes along and uses it to write a record. One other thing the tablet makers sometimes did is put a piece of straw or string through the center of the tablet. So I'm going to make another folded tablet now, and I'm going to put this piece of string in it. So we'll roll out this sheet. And again, I'm going to fold this up, but this time I'm going to put the string through, running lengthways along it. There you go, you can see the clay is a bit drier now. It's cracking a lot along the edges. I'm going to need to use some water on my finger to neaten that up a lot. And again, we need to flatten it out to cover over this seam on the back if I was going to use this tablet to write on and get a flat surface for writing. But here you can see I've got a tablet, a fairly rough one, with string coming out both sides. Now, in the real tablets, the string or the straw doesn't survive now, but we can see the holes that they left behind on the edges of the tablets. Now, adding a string like this might help to make the tablet more sturdy, like the folding did, but it also has another potential benefit. Tablets would sometimes have been made and written in one part of the palace and then carried to another part for filing, or some tablets might have been written in other parts of the territory and then brought to the palace where the central administration was. We're not totally sure, we generally only find the tablets in the palaces, but it's definitely a possibility. Now, once the tablets have dried out, there's a risk of them breaking if they're being transported around. But if this happens to a tablet with a piece of string through it, the pieces are going to be kept together and won't get lost. So here's a tablet that I took it on a flight to the UK, brought it back here to Athens. You can see it's broken in several pieces, but the string is still keeping them together, so I would still be able to read whatever text was written on it if I were a Mycenaean tablet writer. Now I've shown you some different ways to make tablets, it's time to write something in Linear B on one of them. So I'm going to take the first one I made, and I'm going to use this pointed sort of skewer. You could use like a wooden skewer or a toothpick, something sharp like that. And I'm going to write a very simple entry. Linear B texts are generally very short, not even written in full sentences a lot of the time. So let's say that I want to write that Anna has got 4 sheep, for instance. I can do that very simply as just Anna, sheep, 4, is how you would normally write that. Now, linear B signs stand for syllables, not for single sounds like the letters of the English or Greek alphabet. So my name Anna has 2 syllables, so I'm going to write it now with 2 signs. First, I'm going to write A. And then I'm going to write na. Now, for sheep, I'm not going to write out the word sheep. I'm going to use a different kind of sign called an ideogram. That's, rather than spelling out the word, that's a single sign that represents like the idea of a sheep, hence ideogram. If I draw it now, it's kind of a very schematic sheep head on a stick, is really what it looks like. And then I'm going to write the number 4, which is just 4 vertical strokes. Now, there's a lot more explanation on the worksheets that go with this video on how to write in linear B. You can try writing an entry like this with your own name and various different objects I've listed the ideograms for, or there are some actual tablets that you could try copying. So now you've seen how making and writing experimental tablets can help us understand how they were made in the Mycenaean palaces. It's time for you to try making and writing your own with the worksheet that's linked below this video. I'd love to hear from you about how it goes and see any pictures of the results. You can get in touch with me by email at apj454@gmail.com or Twitter at Anna P. Judson. Thanks to everyone involved in helping me both carry out this research and make this video. And finally, thank you for watching and have fun making tablets.